Hello and welcome to this next tutorial in GUI development in Python, and today we're going to add some functionality to our diary program and get it all working. So the first thing you're going to need to do is, underneath where we wrote last time from tkinter import star, we need to also import the web browser library. Next we're going to define all of the functions that are going to get our code working. So the first thing we've got is def open file, and this is going to basically open the file that we're creating in Notepad. And to do that, we just use the code webbrowser.open, then brackets and speech marks, the name of our text file, symbols. Next thing we're going to do is define a function which will allow us to also open up our diary in idle, because why not? And here we just use some simple code. We make a variable, we've called it text file, set it equal to open. And again, the same name here, the same name for your text file that you used earlier, and in R mode, which is read mode. Then we can just use in one line of code, print text file.read, open and close brackets, and obviously a closing bracket, and then, always good practice, we close the text file. And that function will just handle printing it back into idle for us. Next bit of functionality we're going to need is to allow the user to actually write their diary2 file. Here we go diary entry equals textbox.get, open and close brackets. This will get whatever text they've typed into the entry box and store it in the variable text diary entry. Here we then set the variable diary entry equal to itself plus backslash n. Now that might seem a bit weird, but what we're doing here is we're formatting it so that there's a new line after every entry. So instead of having everything on one line when you read it back, each diary entry will be on its own line, which makes it a lot more readable. This next line of code, you don't need it, but it's very useful. What this will do, once the user's submitted their diary entry, it will delete everything from the text box field. So it just makes it a bit more professional. Then we open it in append mode, so now we're opening the text file in append mode A, which allows us to keep adding to the text file without overwriting anything. Again, very useful. We then write the contents from the text box into the text file, and then we close it. Simples. Finally, it's always useful to be able to actually close our GUI down nicely, rather than just sort of clicking on the X at the top. So here we can just define a function called close, where we go mgui.destroy, and that will just get rid of it and close it down. Again, quite nice to have. This code here is identical to what you wrote in the last tutorial, so you can skip over that. Beneath that code, so underneath in your code where it says this line of code here, there's a few additions. So last time you just had this line, but we've added a comma here and command equals read file. So what that's going to do is it's going to call the function read file if that option is selected. We've got two more lines of code here, almost identical, but we've got different labels, open in Notepad, and the command we're calling is open file, so that will send the code to the open file function up here, and that will open up in Notepad. And then finally, our last one on the drop down menu is quit, and that will call the function close, and that will get rid of our window. This again is identical to what you had last time, and again here this is almost identical to what you had last time. The only difference here is this line here. So last time the submit button didn't do anything if you clicked on it, whereas now of course we want to be able to actually write whatever the user's put into the text box to the text file. So we've just added after the submit, comma, command equals write to file, and that will allow us to use this function here to be able to save our diary to our text file. And finally, make sure this is at the very bottom of your code. That's important. That's our main loop to keep the window open. Okay, that's it. Let's just see it running. And if you've got all that in, you should end up with something like this. And here we can click on File. We can quit our program and it just closes it. Really nice and handy. Run it again. So now we can just put a diary entry. I can make GUI, for example, we can submit it. You can see that destroy command working now. It's got rid of that. So that's quite nice. It's ready for the next diary entry. We can now open up our diary in Notepad. As you can see, there you go. That's the last thing we submitted. Working beautifully. You can close that down. We can now also open this up in Idle. And as you can see here, it's opened it up in Idle as well. So we've got that functionality added in. And you can also obviously close and quit, which we saw earlier. Well, I hope you enjoyed that tutorial. Have fun with it, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.